Sophie grows more and more distant, and bolder. She creates hideaways and passages through vents to get out of my reach. She's constantly interfering with my work, trying to command remades, playing with lab devices, milling about my new Fumi amplifier. At least her small head and body cannot carry the weight of the parts required for the amplifier to function. After I caught her trying to use my latest prototype on herself, I took her teddy bear as punishment and safely locked up the device on the top floor. There's no way she can ever get in there, and so my tests can continue, without any hassles, I hope. The toy, the stupid little bear, always melts her heart. It will come in handy. I can use it to control her. I might give it back to her once she behaves according to her purpose.
Feel vulnerable and exposed. stare of those people, those monsters. I can't believe they used to be human once. And are those crystals inside of them an infestation put inside of healthy people? Or is this some kind of new species sprouted up, born and bred in this hellhole?
Marcus is returning. I cannot let him enter the Arks. The Bureau will have sent an elite commander unit along with him for sure. I want to remove him from our life. Neither Sophie nor I need him. Our place is here, in the tower. His place is at the bottom of the sea.
Well, at least I know what happened to me now. And how I ended up washed up on that rock. It was my own wife that did it to me. I need a key. The power to the elevator should now be restored. Ah, the elevator shaft leading to the main generator room of the tower. I need to get there to shut down this abomination. I need to use a charged up abrogator to destroy the barrier.